Hello my dear students, last class we have discussed addition and subtraction of integers and closure property. Today we are going to discuss next property, commutative property under addition. Okay, so what is the commutative property under addition? It's very simple, that is a plus b equals to b plus a. A and b are n into integers. So this is the commutative property under addition, that is a plus b equals to b plus a. In general, how to write this one? For any two integers, a and b, a plus b equals to b plus a. Okay, let's take one example. So first one, 3 plus 4 equals to 4 plus 3. What is the value of 3 plus 4? That is 7. And 4 plus 3 equals to 7. So this is the commutative property under addition. So this is the first example. Let's take another example. Minus 5 plus 3. So how to write this one? 3 plus of minus 5. So here both the numbers are having the sign, different sign, that is minus and plus. So first subtract it. After that, keep the bigger number sign. 5 minus 3, 2. And bigger number sign is minus. And here, right side, here plus is there, here minus is there. So first multiply. Plus into minus. Plus into minus, minus. That is 3 minus 5. Here also number 5 in different sign. So subtract it. What will be the answer? Minus 2. Okay, these are the two examples for commutative property under addition. Okay, so just write down your own examples of commutative property under addition by your own. Okay, don't take the help of your friends, brothers, sisters. Okay, next commutative property under addition. Next one is commutative property under subtraction. So, this is also same, but here just declare the positive sign. Okay. What is that? Commutative property under subtraction. A minus B equals to B minus A. Okay. This is the commutative property under subtraction. First, take one example. Okay. After that, I will tell you. Okay. Take one example. Take simple integers. 5 minus 3 equals to 3 minus 5. Okay. 5 minus 3 value is, you know that answer is 2. And here 3 minus 5. Both the numbers are in different signs, that is plus and minus. So subtract it after that. Keep the bigger number sign, that is minus 2. Is 2 is equals to minus 2? No. That means these are not equals to minus 2. That means commutative property under subtraction is not holds for integers. A minus B is not equals to B minus A. Okay, this is very simple. Don't make it complicated. Okay, in the first one, A plus B equals to B plus A. But in the second one, A minus B is not equals to B minus A. In general, how to write that one? For any two integers, for any two integers a and b, a minus b is not equals to b minus a. So this is the commutative property under subtraction, but this is not holds for integer, only holds for addition, not for subtraction. Okay, so next, this property, after the commutative property, next property, associative property. So next one is associative property. Okay. Let us write four examples for commutative property under subtraction. Okay. So next one is associative property under first addition. addition. Okay. So what is that? A plus bracket B plus C equals to bracket A plus B plus C. So this is the general statement of associative property under addition. Okay. In general, how to write this one? For any integers. For any integers a, b and c, we can say what we have to say, a plus b plus c equals to a plus b plus c. Okay, let's take one example. Okay, then only you have to understand the associative property under addition. So take one example. Take integers 2 plus 3 plus 4. Okay, next, how to write this one? First in the left side, bracket is in the last part. But in the right side, bracket is in the first part. Okay, here 2 plus 3 plus 4. So, next one, 2 plus 3 plus 4 value 7. And here 2 plus 3 value 5 plus 4, 2 plus 7, 9 equals to 5 plus 4, 9. That means addition holds for integer. Which property? Associative property under addition holds for integers. Like this, just check it for subtraction. Associative property under subtraction. Just check it, okay? So write down minimum 4 examples of this associative property under addition. Okay. Next, check it for subtraction. So what is that? A minus B minus C equals to A minus B minus C. Okay. Before going to the statement, first check it. For example, just check it. Okay. Take one example. Take the integers 3 minus 4 minus 2 equals to 3 minus 4 minus 2. Okay. First solve this one. 3 minus as is 4 minus 2, 2. Here 3 minus 4. Here numbers are having different sign, plus and minus. So first subtract from small number from bigger number. That means 4 minus 3, that is 1. And bigger number sign is minus. Minus 1 and minus 2. Here 3 minus 2 value 1. Here numbers are having same sign. So first add the numbers 2 plus 1, 3 and sign minus. Keep it as is. 1 equals to minus 3? No. 1 is not equals to minus 3. That means this is not holds for subtraction. Only associative property holds for addition, not for subtraction. Don't get complicated, okay? It's very easy. Okay. Next, take another example. 2 minus 5 minus 3. 2 minus 5 minus 3. Solve this one. 2 minus 5 minus 3 means 2. 2 minus 5. That is minus 3 and minus 3. 2 minus 2, 0. Here minus 3 and minus 3. What will be the answer? Minus 6. That means 0 is not equal to minus 6. In general, how to write this one? This one is not holds for subtraction. We can write it as, in general, for any integer, A, B, and C, A minus B minus C is not equals to A minus B minus C. Okay, this is the associative property under subtraction. This is not holds for subtraction. So only associative property holds for addition. Okay. At the end, my dear students, I hope all of you understand the concept of commutative property and associative property.